You faced Manny twice. You won one. You lost one. You never faced Floyd, right? As a fighter or a trainer, you didn't get. You weren't part of a camp. What did you make of the Mayweather-Pacquiao fight? As a person who already been there to that level.
What I think about the fight, I'm just very realistic. About the Manny Pacquiao and Floyd Mayweather fight, I'm very realistic. What you guys saw, that's what's gonna happen. But a lot of people get carried away by, I hope Floyd gets knocked out. You know, like I told everybody, maybe 90% of the world that watched the fight were hoping to see Mayweather go down. That's the reason why they bought the fight. But it was not gonna happen. Mayweather is too smart. He's a welterweight. I mean, he is very good, slick fighter. And Manny Pacquiao can only hit you if you go look for him. You know, Manny Pacquiao, every time he's looked great is when fighters go looking for him and he will just destroy them. If you move on Manny, he don't know what to do. I mean, of course, a lot of people say, oh, Manny Pacquiao throws 100 punches. Yeah, but when you got a target in front of you, but when you got somebody that moves on you, you can't throw, especially when you throw and you get hit at the same time.
How would Tim Bradley do against Floyd? Floyd has two fights left. What do you think about that? Tim Bradley, Floyd Mayweather.
It will be a boring fight.
Why?
Because I can tell you, I mean, Bradley's my fighter, and Floyd Mayweather to me is one of the greatest. I'm very realistic. It will be a boring fight.
Okay.
I mean, if I wasn't his trainer, I wouldn't even watch it. Why? Because it will be a fight, it will be like a chess game. You know what I mean? It'll be more here than anything. I mean, like, who's going to make the move? It'll be, I mean, the clock's going to be ticking, and these guys are going to be like, come on. That's what it's gonna be.
Okay.
And when there's a little bit of exchange, isn't that gonna be what people wanna see?
What about Matisse? Good fight for Tim?
Matisse will be a good fight for Tim because Matisse is a fighter that, you know, comes and you know, I was actually surprised he boxed Provodnikov in the early rounds. If he would have stayed there with Provodnikov, he wouldn't have lasted. But the thing is this, he's a great boxer. You wanna beat Ruslan Provodnikov, you gotta box, you gotta move on him. I mean, Timothy didn't listen to me that night, but we could have made it a boring fight. But Timothy decided to show the people, you know, I got this.
What about, I know Bradley, he dismissed Lamont Peterson, you know, a couple of years back, shut him down for 12 rounds. He even knocked him down. And then he saw Danny Garcia, he clearly got outboxed. They gave him the knock. How do you feel about Bradley and Danny Garcia?
You know, Danny Garcia would be a great fight, you know, but... I already
got outboxed by Peterson.
Yeah, you know what? I'm going to tell you something. I already dialed in Danny Garcia. Mauricio Herrera beat him.
Yeah.
Let's be realistic.
Yeah.
I mean...
That's Bradley's sparring partner, no?
You know, I mean, Mauricio Herrera has given us a lot of rounds. So, yeah. Okay. See you guys.
We're walking, coach.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekback. And you can follow me on Instagram @EllieSekback.